The budget smartphone market has become a crowded place with companies flocking the space with their latest devices. Today, we'll be doing a camera comparison of three devices in this price bracket. The Smartron T-Phone P versus the Infinix Hot S3 versus the Honor 9 Lite. Hey, this is Srihari from Mr. Phone and let's get into this camera comparison. Before jumping into the video, if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, please do that and also click that bell icon right next to it so that you get notified for all the cool tech videos that we put out. Let's quickly take a look at their camera specs. So on the Smartron T-Phone P, we have a 13 megapixel camera on the back and a 5 megapixel camera on the front. The Infinix Hot S3 has a 13 megapixel camera on the back and a 20 megapixel camera on the front. The Honor 9 Lite has 4 cameras here. So a 13 megapixel plus 2 megapixel camera setup on both the front and the back. Taking a look at this first image, the Infinix, the T-Phone P and the Honor 9 Lite take very good looking image here, with the T-Phone P's image looking much clearer. Even zooming in, the Smartron T-Phone P has much sharper image. The T-Phone P has really impressed me here, because even compared to the Honor 9 Lite, it is so sharp. The Honor's image has a lot of saturated colors, which comes obviously through the software processing and can be seen in the reds and the blues, but at the same time, the green color is entirely washed out. The Smartron T-Phone P has clicked a really good looking picture here and is the winner for this set of images. In this next image, the Infinix S3 takes the most appealing looking image with a slightly warmer tone. The performance of the S3 is very impressive here with minimal noise levels. The T-Phone P also provides a sharp image with somewhat washed colors but very less noise again. The Honor 9 Lite, while it looks very similar to the T-Phone P's image, has much more noise, which is very clearly visible if we zoom into the sky. This is a pattern that you will see even in the upcoming images. Even in this next image, the Smartron and Honor take very good looking pictures, and while the colors on the Smartron look much better, the Honor has more details with less saturated colors. The Infinix does just fine with washed out colors and blurred details. Now this image will make a lot of you easily gravitate towards the Honor 9 Lite due to the vibrant colors. The details too, although a little blurry, have been preserved very well. The Smartron 2 does a great job, and I think a lot of people might like it better due to its closeness to the real situation. The Hot S3's picture, although has real colors, the details and clarity are not quite there. This image again has me leaning towards the Smartron. You can see how impressed I am with it. It has very appealing colors along with natural tones. So the Honor 9 Lite, due to its software processing, pushes the blue of the building to a very unnatural color, along with the lower right area being a bit too white. The Smartron really shines in this picture with better colors and more details too, which are very visible when you zoom in. Even the sky in the 9 Lite has too much noise compared to a clearer sky in Smartron and the Infinix 2. The Honor 9 Lite, however, has done one thing really well, which is preserve colors in those trees. The details are entirely lost, but the colors are there for those who might like that. Now in this next image, the Smartron is again my choice. The colors look very natural and that slightly warmer tone makes things very pleasing for me. The Infinix 2 has a good looking image, however the lack of certain details puts me off. The 9 Lite here produces great dynamic range but sadly has washed out colors for me. The pattern is prevalent here, where the Honor 9 Lite has too much noise in the background. This next set of images are a very good example of how Honor just boosts the colors to the extreme. The Smartron's picture is very close to what the actual colors look like, and the Infinix 2 does a respectable job. And this pattern is evident in all the images we took. Now this next image is where the Honor 9 Lite really shines. The dynamic range is so crazy and the Smartron and Infinix just blowed out the entire backgrounds. The Honor 9 Lite does a very good job here and comes out on top. Now coming to the indoor shots, while the images look good from a distance, zooming in we can see that the Honor 9 Lite really shines here. The details are on point and the colors are not too overpowering. The Infinix Hot S3 has the next best picture with respectable details and colors. The Smartron T-Phone P performs poorly and has the least details. More indoor shots bring back the noise into Honor in some places, but overall image quality really shines on the Honor. The Smartron and Infinix Hot S3 both do respectable jobs with good looking images.
This next image was taken in extremely low light situation, with this wall pattern being lit just by a light from outside the room. The Smartron surprisingly does a great job here with better details and colors. The Infinix is a close second with slightly more noise, and the Honor does a poor job with too much noise and washed out colors. Now again, in this extremely low lit situation where I didn't expect any of them to deliver a legible picture, the Infinix does a plausible job with enough details and colors. Now when it comes to selfies, the Honor 9 Lite and Infinix both do very well, with the Infinix surprisingly having more of the skin softening which usually the Honor devices are known for. For me, I like the tones on the Infinix better. The Honor has a slightly greenish tint here which I think is very visible. Zooming in, the details are clearly more on the Infinix thanks to the 20 megapixel selfie centric camera on the front. The Smartron does a real poor job, and that without a doubt is one of the weakest links of the phone. The selfies are just very noisy and have poor color reproduction. Now looking at the portrait mode, the Infinix is my choice here. Skin tones are pleasing and the blur, although not perfect, has been dealt with pretty well. The impressive part is that the Infinix Hot S3 managed to do the blur with just a single camera, where the Honor 9 Lite has two on the front. The Smartron T-Phone P does not have a portrait mode as of now. The Infinix has a flash at the front for low light selfies too, and the result is not very bad. The images might come out blurry sometimes, which is mostly due to the lack of light. But even then, the colors and details are very appealing. The Honor 9 Lite uses a bright widescreen as flash, and it does just fine. Before deciding the comparison, we even debated if we should put the Honor 9 Lite here since it would crush the other two. But to my utter surprise, the Smartron T-Phone P produced stunning images with great detail and colors. A full review of the T-Phone P is also dropping in the next 2 days, and I think it's going to be a must watch, so stay subscribed for that. The Honor 9 Lite did have a lot of noise in almost every image I took, but had better dynamic range with the shadows and highlights being preserved really well. The Infinix Hot S3 also did just fine in most situations, but where it really shined was selfies. The details were just perfect, and the portrait mode on the front camera was near perfect. Now, in a nutshell, the Smartron is a great choice if you don't take a lot of selfies and want really good looking images at this price. The Infinix Hot S3 is a much better choice for selfie enthusiasts with sharp selfies and a great portrait mode. The Honor 9 Lite is an overall good camera with generally good looking pictures, saturated colors and appealing selfies. That's it for this one. Thank you so much for watching. This is Srihari from Mr. Phone, and I'll catch you in the next one.